I would rather stoke the fires o' hell than do what I just had done. I would rather walk frae here to Perth with stains in both my sheen. And I'd rather die for want o' breath than die for want o' love. And it's all because Mcfarlane married Susie. Susie's cankered feyther and mine could never agree. So lang er I get o'er the gate, he'd set his dogs on me. So I sent my friend Mcfarlane to see what he could do. That's Mcfarlane o' the sprouts o' Burnieboosie. I dinna like Mcfarlane, it's off a plain to state. His lugs would cast a shady o'er a 6 foot gate. He's half a mean and slithery, sleek it like a snake. Mcfarlane, oh, the sprouts o' Burnieboosie. Mcfarlane spake nae words for me, but plenty for his cell. He praised the lassie's barley scones, her baking and her kale, till her feyther cried out, "Sprouty lad, try your luck yoursel." Dame Mcfarlane, oh, the sprouts o' Burnieboosie. Mcfarlane is the grimmest chiel for miles and miles aroon. They use his photograph to scare the rottens frae the toon. But he up and asked my Susie if she kindly would come doon and be mistress at his house in Burnieboosie. I dinna like Mcfarlane, it's awfu but it's true. His mouth is just as big as Meg McPherson's coo. They live down in a hovel, she feeds them wi' a shovel. Mcfarlane, oh, the sprouts o' Burnieboosie. He's the man up in merit, my wee Susie.